Honourable Member for Calgary Foothills.
Mr. Speaker, over the weekend, I held my fourth annual Calgary Veterans Food Bank Drive. The Veterans Food Bank targets services to veterans, ex-service, widows, dependents who are in temporary financial difficulties. About 50 volunteers went out in northern Calgary, where we raised over $3,500 worth of food. In addition, we raised over $1,500 in spontaneous donations at the Alberta Wide Rally at McDougall Center. But our volunteers at the doors could tell there were people giving who were also down on their luck. Normally, the Veterans Food Bank does about 90 hampers a month. This year, they're up to 140 a month, a 55% increase. They also normally spend $10,000 to purchase food. This year it's $50,000. And that extra money comes from the Poppy Fund, the money raised from the red flowers on your lapels. The carbon tax will cost the food bank more to heat and power the building and will cut back on donations received. Traditionally, people think of veterans as senior citizens. That's no longer the case. Due to Canada's involvement in Afghanistan, a veteran can be in his 20s. Younger veterans used to find work in the oil patch, but the oil patch isn't hiring. And it is not through lack of the effort. Some veterans have applied for work more than 300 times and still no job. Last week, it was revealed the unemployment rate in Calgary is 10.2%, the worst rate of any major city in Canada. Join me in thanking my volunteers, especially Stephen and Karen Davis and Emery Pritchard, for hosting and feeding the team while we help the Calgary veterans community.
Here, here. Here, here.